All right, when I mentioned this graph and we looked at it, it looks like it's really close right there. I can't really tell, but it also looks like it's below the line. So I'm going to go look at the table. And the table, I want to evaluate the function between negative 5 and 0. So if I look from negative 5 to 0, well, it's increasing, right? But they're all still negative. So it's not a question of it jumped from positive to negative, negative to positive, and it was obvious that it crossed. I can't really tell. So I need to evaluate a little bit more, which means it could happen in between something there. So if I go back to the graph, I'm going to zoom in just for grins here. And let's look and see what happens. Look, it crossed. It crossed between negative 1 and 0. And we couldn't tell because it is so small. And we can trace it. We can figure out where that happened. It happens about negative 0.5. So this crosses and has a 0 between negative 1 and 0. It's very difficult to tell from just the table. You have to focus and look at the graph or break it down even farther to see what's happening between the integers. Okay, now let's look at end behavior. When you're dealing with end behavior, again, this is another way that we can describe the behavior of the function, and we're going to talk about how it's behaving on the far left, how is it behaving on the far right. We use words such as the function is rising or it's falling or it's going towards infinity or it's going towards negative infinity or it's going up or it's going down. You know, very technical terms. All I want is big picture. What is it behave? How is it behaving? Very often when we do the left end, you're going to see the limit of this function as x approaches the far left. So as it's approaching a negative infinity, the x values, what is this function doing? How is it behaving? So likewise, if you're going to be describing the right end behavior, you're going to say, take the limit as x approaches a positive infinity. Way over here, as x is approaching a huge positive number, what is the function doing? And that's how you can denote that. I don't think your textbook at this point is using the limit notation. We'll do that later. I think it's just using the arrows and the function notation. For example, if I wanted to know the limit here as x is approaching a negative 0. So I want to know the left end behavior of function g, this function that I just drew. Then I want to know over here as x is approaching a huge negative number, this graph, the function is going towards negative infinity. Okay, it's falling. It's falling, falling down. You can do any of those. I would prefer the negative infinity. Let's take the right-hand side. You can just look at the graph and you can tell that the limit as x is approaching positive infinity of that function is going to be a positive infinity. And that's rising, going up. Okay? Let's look at this function over here. Now this function f has an asymptote here at y equals 2. So if you want to know the left end as x is huge, gets really, 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 really small, let's do the left end first. This approaches a negative infinity. This way I'll write this one as your book does. Your book says x is approaching negative infinity, so the function f is approaching what value? As it's getting very, very, x is getting very, very small, that graph is getting, function is getting closer and closer and closer to what value? That's 2, okay, at your asymptote. Likewise, if x is approaching positive infinity, a huge number at this branch of the graph, then the function is also going to approach to. So you can have the end behavior approach a specific value, especially if it's an asymptote. You can also have the end behavior go in opposite directions. They could both be going up. You can have a parabola, right, that's going up. You could have a parabola that's going down, and they're both negative infinity. Just depends on the nature of the function. Okay? When you come to class, we will work on these exercises for section 1.3. Thank you.